Hello students, welcome to Competitive Exam Library YouTube channel. Today we are going to see what is the analogous systems. Okay, so we are going to see analogous systems between electrical and mechanical. So we are going to see what is the analogous components we can compare this electrical to mechanical, and you can convert mechanical to electrical. So we are going to see the analogous systems of the different system, that is electrical and mechanical system. Let us see in this mechanical systems. We are already know in mechanical systems we are having two types of systems. We know already, one is translational mechanical systems, one is translational mechanical systems, another is rotational mechanical systems. These are the two systems we are having. So under this, in translational mechanical systems we can see another classification here. Whenever you have force voltage analogy, we can say it as force voltage analogy. Next is force current analogy. So here force current analogy. So in the rotational mechanical systems also we are having torque voltage, that is torque and voltage analogy, and here torque and current analogy. So these are the different analogies what we are going to see. Let us consider first translational mechanical systems. In that we are going to complete force voltage and force current analogy in this video. So let us start the force voltage analogy, right? So now we are going to start with the force voltage analogy. So here we will consider force voltage analogy. So in this case of this force voltage analogy, we are having, so that means first we are having what is the input. So what is the input we have to take and what is the output we have to take. See, for this force voltage analogy, what is the input here is, so let us take this side, let us take first mechanical systems. So let us consider the, first we will consider this side mechanical systems, next on this side we will consider the electrical systems. So whenever these two systems are compared, we are going to write the individual elements. Next we are going to compare this mechanical systems with electrical systems. Let us see what is the first element we are having. What is the input we are giving for this? Here is input you are giving the force, and the output you are expecting is, what is the output here? It is velocity in this case. Next here input is, what is you are giving, that is because the force voltage analogy, the input will be voltage here and the output will be current through element. Okay, so output will be current through element. So this is the input and output what we are given for the electrical, mechanical and electrical systems. So let us consider first element is, so let us consider first element is dashpot. So dashpot we are already know here, how we are going to take the dashpot, it is having like this. Okay, so the dashpot will be connected to one reference, so that is B. You are applied a force on this dashpot, then it is having a displacement x. So V is equals to, we can write velocity as rate of change of displacement. We can say F will be B into dx by dt, that is also equals to B into V, where V is the velocity of the body. So, this is what we have written. So, whenever if you see represent with the same equation with the resistance. So, if you are light, if you are write the resistance, whenever you are connected to the one voltage source, let us connect this voltage source will be, because of that current starts flowing, there will be some voltage will be generated across this resistor also. We can write E is equals to V, that is also equals to I into R. So, we can write it as E is equals to I into R, that is also equals to V is equals to I into R, we can write. Next, if you observe, let us consider mass in this mechanical system. Let us consider the mass in the mechanical system. So, whenever you have connected the mass in the mechanical system, so let us consider this is mass M and there is a force F will be there. There will be displacement, acceleration will be there, that will be d square x by dt square, that is also equals to dv by dt. And whenever you can write F equation, that will be M into d square x by dt square, or we can write M into dv by dt, M into dv by dt. Let us consider if you take the inductor. So, you know the inductor, so inductor equation relation will be, whenever you apply some voltage for this inductor, what will happen? The voltage across the inductor can be written as, what is the voltage across the current is flowing here. So, voltage can be written as, what we can write? So, voltage can be is equals to L into di by dt. So, if you compare these two equations, let us compare these two equations. What equations? Here, if you compare this one and this one, see, observe this. Here, the mass can be replaced with the inductor and velocity can be replaced with the current. So, velocity can be replaced with the current. So, you can identify here also, velocity is regarding to the current and frictional constant B is according to resistance. No, so now you can compare the terms. In the next term, so what is another term we are having here also? Another term is we are missing is spring constant. Let us consider a spring constant. Here it is also connected to the reference K with the displacement X whenever you are applied some force. So, on this, whenever you are applied some force, X can be written as it is that is integration of velocity dt, because X is equals to dx by dt is equals to V. So, if you take X is equals to integration of V dt, we can write. So, let us write the force equation. So, we can write force equation as K into X. So, we can write in place of X, we can write integral V dt. Let us consider a electrical system. So, if you are having a capacitor, we know already capacitor can be written as, so whenever you are connected a voltage source for this, E will be is connected, current starts flowing, there will be some voltage will be induced across the capacitor. We can write, so I is equals to C into dV by dt, but our target is we are taking force voltage. So, you have to take the voltage. So, dV we can write it as dV is equals to 1 by C I dt. So, whenever you take the integration on both sides, V is equals to, we can write 1 by C integral I dt. So, now you compare these two equations. So, let us see, spring constant can be written as inversely proportional to the capacitor, and this velocity we are already identified that is equals to current. So, now if you write this analog is they both are equal, then you are going to get some analogies for the force voltage analogy you are going to get. Let us write that. So, we will write that force voltage analogy what you are going to get whenever you have completed this. So, we will write first force will be compared with force we got it as we are taken with the voltage V here we got. Next, velocity we got here in case of this as current I in case of the electrical systems. Next, let us consider displacement. So whenever you take a displacement, so that will be equals to here charge, here charge Q. So I will explain, because current is equals to dQ by dt here. So what about here? Displacement can be written as x is equals to, we can write, so dx by dt can be written as here the velocity. So velocity can be here, the velocity can be v, here taken as current, here x can be taken as charge here in case of the electrical systems. Next, dashpot coefficient. So dashpot, frictional dashpot coefficient b can be taken as what we are taking, resistance. So we are getting the resistance R in electrical circuits. Next, whenever you take a mass, the mass can be replaced with inductance L. So that is what we got in electrical circuit, inductance L in electrical circuit. Next, spring constant K. So spring constant K, whenever you are compared with the spring constant K, what you are going to get? Inverse of a capacitance, which we are written above, inverse of capacitance, that is 1 by C, inverse of capacitance 1 by C. Next, let us apply sigma of, that is force, is equals to 0, which is known as Newton's law here in case of the mechanical system. So let us apply the same law here also, sigma of V is equals to 0, then we can say this is KVL in case of the electrical system. So this is the comparison we got in case of the force voltage analogy system. That's all in this video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. So if you have any query, please make a comment in the comment box. Thank you. Thank you very much.